Introducing the Ringwood Hawks, number 5, Abby Lloyd, number 8, Natasha Trapino, number 9, Georgia Plumby, number 14, Courtney Lyons, number 21, Georgia Aitchison, number 24, Cassandra Stringer, and the starting 5 for the Ringwood Hawks, number 4, Piper Goldie, number 6, Nihara Ravajuma, number 7, Rachel Watson, number 12, Kelly Ramos, number 15, Rebecca Moller. Ringwood Hawks, coached by Rob Dielemans, assistant coach Rebecca Sparrow. And the home team, Waverley Falcons, number 11, Shanika Scott. Number 23, Kiara Richardson. Number 24, Liz Thurman. Number 32, Charity Russell. And the starting 5 for the Waverley Falcons. Number 3, Lola Geddes. Number 7, Justin Monsinos. Number 12, Hayley McPhillips. Number 13, Caitlin Angus. And number 22, Michaela Miller. Please be outstanding for the national anthem.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Waverley Basketball Stadium for this, the second Victorian Youth Championship women's game of the weekend. This time it's the Falcons taking on top of the ladder Ringwood Hawks, and it could be one-way traffic here, Liam.
There we go. Yeah, well, after the game last night, it did seem like they'd be a bit out of breath for Waverley. They ended up being on their heels a bit, or from what I saw watching the live stream at home.
Yeah, and also we're going to be down a couple of players as well, not playing in this game for the Falcons. Maddie Borg, Sam Lanby, Jess Robinson and Lauren Mitchell. Into the game comes Elise Thurman and Charity Russell. So not only is it a depleted lineup, but you take Sam Lanby out. She's one of the prolific scorers. Maddie Borg, one of the strong guards. It's going to be tough work for these young ladies who are struggling to get the wins and stay out of the relegation zone.
Especially coming against this top-level side that Ringwood do put up every week.
Yeah, and Rob Dedelins has really got this team firing. Beck Noller, the current player of the month in the Victorian Youth Championship Women. And she is really, really taking this league by storm this year. At only 19 years old, she's got another 3-4 years in this level of competition, and is already suiting up with the Ringwood State Champ Women's team as well. So we're almost ready for a start here at the Falcon's Nest. As we see Jocelyn Montesinos, who unfortunately fouled out last night, Liam, in the third quarter. So she took no part in the fourth quarter. Going up against Rachel Watson. And it is the possession goes to Ringwood in the form of Piper Goldie.
Some strong defense inside the Waverley, right there.
Yeah, Caitlin Anglis played very well indeed last night as Hayley McPhillips. Hayley, I said to her after the game that I thought that was one of the best games I'd seen her play so far. Montesinos misses that. Rebounded there by Watson. It's now with Goldie. Goldie brings the ball down. And the ball's out of bounds. Kelly Roma steps out of bounds there. Ball's in with McPhillips.
Back off to Miller there.
Montesinos kicks it down to Geddes. Geddes' shot doesn't drop.
Back down Ringwood's way to Goldie. Back up top through. I don't know. Solid defense inside still by Waverley. But the ball dropping there for Ringwood.
So it's a 2-0 scoreline.
Ball back up the top there for Becknola.
Another 2 points. Falcons been unable to stop the Hawks' attack at the moment.
But 3 points there to Geddes. Well, I was about to say before that shot they've been holding their own defensively inside, but that easy layup there for Ringwood. Back up the top to McPhillips. Haley took the shot. Missed off the back of the ring. That was a rebound there to Rachel Watson. Almost a loss there by Goldie. Back up top there to Noah. misses. Didn't hit anything there almost. Miller's taking it down for Waverley. Trying to hold it up. See an opening. Gets it across to McPhillips. Back through the hands of Miller. Shot clock going down. Probably do something with it. A bit of turnover there. Good defense from Romas.
So Goldie now with it. She drives.
Couldn't finish. The contested rebound right there for Waverley. McPhillips taking it down. It had it blocked. So a travel is called. So Goldie yet again bringing it down. Three-point attempt from Ringwood, not good. But a contested rebound, going to cause a jump ball. Going to go in the direction of Waverley. Getty's bringing it down. Getting pressured near the half court. McPhillips got it at the three-point line. Through the hands of Miller to Getty's.
Montesinos can't get it to drop. It's been rebounded again by the Ringwood big and Rachel Watson.
Good help defense there from Montesinos. And there we have Caitlin Angus doing some good defense again in the inside. Feel like that was a good amount of defense there from Ringwood to try and force Miller out of the court right there. So Romas got it up top there as Goldie again to Romas. Good moving around the three. But no successful shot there as it misses everything. Oh. So McPhillips holding it up the court for Waverley. Good screen there for Montesinos. Miller trying to find her options. That was Angus taking a long two-pointer. But Ringwood trying to get it down the court quickly. Moving it around. Goldie trying to drive in. No, backs it down. And the three-point attempt missed by Ringwood. The rebound by Miller. Trying to take it herself for a little bit. Wanted to get it to McPhillips, but got it to Angus instead. Couldn't get the 2 points to drop. Back down Ringwood's way. So really good ball movement here by Ringwood. As was that a?
No, it was just a travel.
Oh,
it could have very easily been called as a foul there as Montesinos. Well, it would have been a very gentle foul.
It would have been gentle, but.
Yeah.
I know of some refs who probably might have called it for conservatism. Miller assessing her options, got it to Geddes, taking a three. Missing it long. There's another rebound there to Nola. Goldie got it in the corner. Seen really good ball movement here from Ringwood. As the foul is called this time. And I believe it will be on Russell. Yes, that was right. So Ringwood's ball from the baseline.
Yes, and ladies and gentlemen, if you're watching the stream, we are having some technical difficulties with our internet connection at the moment, so we apologise if there's a bit of buffering. We are trying to swap our connections at the moment to get to a much more stable stream. And it looks like it settled down there, so we apologise for that.
So here we have Goldie at the line taking two shots. Missing a first there. Making a second. The ball came through to McPhillis, but came off a Ringwood player, so it was a turnover there quickly. Two easy points to Ringwood. Phillips tried to get it across the line as quickly as she could. So a foul will be called to Ringwood, and Waverley will get the ball near so there.
Yeah, and a warning on Rachel Watson for delay of game there. And Rod Dienelmans is going to have a chat to her about that. As Michaela Miller gets the ball into Hayley McPhillips.
Miller got the ball back. Tries to drive around her opponent. Got it off Tessa Russell. Back out. McPhillips taking the three. Missing. Almost had the rebound come back to her, but didn't work. Goldie ends up with it. Pass a little too long there. Goldie got it back into the corner of her hands of Lions. Photo missing there, sorry, but Ringwood will still get the time back. And now the second shot missing, going back to the hands of Russell. McPhillips sizing up a opponent. We've got it off in the hands of Richardson instead. Shot didn't go work for her. Came through the hands of Lloyd in the rebound. Goldie has it in the corner. Drives base, but dishes it off to Courtney Lyons. As a timeout is called by Waverley, I believe.
3-9. We'll also take a quick timeout and continue to work on our technical issues. So apologies for the breakup of the stream. We shall be back very shortly. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Hopefully, again, we've made a few tweaks. Hopefully, the stream is a little bit more stable for you. As Waverley attempts to claw this lead back, it's only 6 points at the moment. I should say. It's only... Yeah. We missed that. So 8 points.
So there was a score we missed there somewhere, but...
That's right.
Three-point attempt there from Ringwood. That is good from Georgia Pembury.
And this is not what Coach Brendan Gordon was wanting to see from the girls.
Phillips got off to Miller. Miller wanted to take a shot out of it. Got it to the corner. And a shot there is made. Three-pointer. To Kiara Richardson.
Now, Kiara last night came out and had a blinder. She shot from... really had a very good outside shooting game.
Goldie driving in. Dishes out into the corner.
Abby Lloyd.
Another 3 points go down for him.
Ex-Waverley Falcon Abby Lloyd has... Courtney Lyons kicks that ball out of court.
Had the ball ring dot down there by Scott.
And the ball's gone out of bounds off Miller's hands.
There's 5 seconds to go now in this quarter as Goldie scores for the quarter to finish, which you don't want to see happen for any team.
And we'll leave you there and be back in a minute's time. So welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Falcons Nest as we see the young, and it is a very young squad there from the Falcons at the moment, trying to battle it out with the much more experienced Ringwood team. So position for position, there's probably at least 1 to 2 years age difference along the way.
Well, if you try and think about it, though, the only points so far have been scored by the two youngest players on the court right now.
Yeah. Yeah, so...
Well, that's for 2 points only scored for Waverley.
Yep.
As Ringwood get the ball in. Currently through the hands of Lyons. Got it to Goldie. Tried to get it across the court to Nola. And that's a drive by... Panbury missed again by Ringwood. Panbury came back with the rebound. Goldie got it up top. Now Nola's hands. Goldie's hands again. Dished it into the post. Missed again by Lyons. But finally, Waverley come back with a rebound. Through Miller's hands now. Two-point attempt missed there. As another rebound there for Nola. Three-point attempt is good by Courtney Lyons. Extending that lead even further out. Miller got it up to the three-point line. Moving it around.
Montesinos misses. Rebounded by Goldie. Goldie driving quickly down the floor. She's got runners in front. They're going to kick it out. Miller with the intercept. Kayla Miller pulls it up. Looks for options. Finds it in Angus. Caitlin Angus to Montesinos. Back to Miller. Miller's shot goes up and misses completely. This was last night, that was exactly the same thing that happened with Miller early in the game. She missed all of her outside shots. Came good in the latter half, but by then it was too late.
Another miss there by Ringwood. Miller got the ball again, but she's surrounded by all the green shirts. Back in the hands of Caitlin Angus. Now with the ball into Kiara Richardson. Angus got it again. Another three-point attempt there by Richardson. No good. As Goldie bringing it down. Drives through. Misses the shots. Almost had a rebound there from Lamontesino, but ended up in the hands of Waverley. And a whistle has been blown. I'm not sure what the call was.
So it must have been a violation of some sort.
Travel.
A travel call.
Travel, we've been told.
Yeah. So that was good from our camera person, Michelle.
At least she was paying attention then.
Yep.
Ringwood taking a shot, missing it. We got the offensive rebound in the end. Back into the post in the hands of La Motticella. As Montesinos has it. Got it up top to Angus. Miller's got on the wing. Driving in. Dishing out. Angus gets blocked. As Ringwood trying to move it down quickly. Unable to convert again. Bring it down. Miller's got the screen for her. Couldn't get it to work. She's got room. Dishes it out. Long two. Misses. Come on to Sinos. Went for the block, but nowhere near fast enough to keep up with her. As we have a timeout called again by Waverley. As the scores stand, 26-6.
So a 20-point game at this point in time, and this is literally disaster for Waverley. It's not going to get any better, I don't think. But hopefully you're enjoying the stream. It looks to have stabilised, and cross our fingers, the internet gods will let us keep streaming it to you without any interruption. We'll be back shortly. So the ref's bringing the ball back onto court, and it'll be the Falcons' ball.
As Angus takes it in, gets it to Miller. As you can see, Ringwood are already trying to press up on them. Ball over on the wing to Miller. Gets it inside. Unable to go for Richardson. Ringwood bringing it back quickly with settling it down on. Shot there. Made. For Loma Tessina. Loma Tessella, sorry. Richardson had it up top. Gave it to Montesinos. Moving around, trying to see what she can do. Angus took a shot, missed, but Miller comes up with the offensive rebound. Moving it around again. Montesinos moving it back into the corner with Angus and getting those 2 points for her team. Keeping it. 20-point game still doesn't sound too positive, but every point still helps in this time of the game. But 3 more points goes towards Beck Nola. Waverley moving it around slowly. Angus to Truma. Couldn't hold on to it as the ball is stolen by Nola. And given to Watson there for the easy 2 points. Miller moving it across. Got into the corner of Angus. Angus driving baseline, stops and attracts by the defense. Montesinos put it up. Bounced off the ring for her. That was Ringwood backing down. Got the hands on the offensive rebound.
Came off Waverley's hands though, so it'll still be a Hawks ball. And wholesale changes from the Waverley bench as Miller, Montesinos and Kiara Richardson sits down.
So Ringwood getting into baseline. Foul before she went up for the shot though, so back for Ringwood as Watson was fouled. Got it in the corner, back out to the wing. The other wing, moving it across. Some good movement in the key there for Ringwood. This ball being held up there. Nice work. A good mid-range shot there with no defense around there, but
Abby Lloyd
came up with the offensive rebound, giving Ringwood 2 more points to the board.
Abby, of course, on Waverley Junior, played quite some time for this very team, and quite a few minutes in the Champ Women's squad as well. Moved to Ringwood, and she has absolutely slotted in beautifully into the Ringwood rotations.
So as a foul is called, we'll have Angus pass the ball in from the baseline. Ball up top there with Shascott. McPhillips holding it up, waiting for a play to happen. Double brought in there. Ball in the corner. Shot misses. Almost brought in for the rebound.
2 points again. So Falcons are hurting on the rebound. And there's
unfortunate.
No, that was...
It was, but it's unfortunate.
I'm surprised the whistle wasn't blown just a fraction earlier than that. As Haley pulled up and dragged her feet.
But at least the right call was made. So there we have Georgia Atchison brought the ball down for him. Into the hands of Courtney Lyons. Waiting for a shot. Missed there, into the hands for the offensive rebound of Abby Lloyd. And she gets fouled, so she'll have two shots on the line.
Just missed that on the replay.
As the shot is missed there. But an offensive rebound to Ringwood makes it all too easy for another possession. Have a great drive baseline there by Kelly Romas. A foul near the baseline as Lola Geddes was trying to drive there.
Yeah, she's very quick, Lola.
So ball out to Geddes. Drive around her players and got two more points for her team.
She's just about the leading scorer for at the moment, I think, for Waverley.
Yes, she is now with those 2 points.
Ailing brings the ball back down. Looks for options, finds Geddes. Geddes spots up for another three.
Missed it. Coming back the other way with the hands of Atchison. Goldie hold it up top. And that was Abby Lloyd there. Stayed a little too long under the key. Getting a turnover there. So McPhillis will be the first to have the ball through their hands. As we see, Russell got the ball. McPhillis back in her hands. Geddes driving in. Back to McPhillis. To Russell, to McPhillis. A shot up by Russell, but missed everything altogether. You see Goldie tried to go for a long bounce pass there, taken off by Waverley. McPhillis tried to drive in. Got it well to Geddes. Geddes, good pass off. Shot unable to be finished off there.
And here's Goldie. Goldie brings the ball quickly back down, and that's the story of the night there, Liam, is that Falcons are struggling to get the ball down and get it to the basket. And when they do, it just comes back so quickly that they really don't know what to do.
Geddes with the ball, driving past her opponent. Got it out into the corner. Three-pointer missed there by... I believe it was Russell. No. That was Truman. As the three-pointer just missed to end the half. We have Ringwood now leading Waverley 41-10 at the halftime break, which is all one way. Been a one-way traffic throughout this game so far.
And we'll be back shortly.
So Chris Arkell, Waverley Falcons, state champ men.
Talia Higgs, Waverley state champ women.
Paul McCoy, Waverley Falcons, state champions.
Tom Boyle, Waverley Falcons, state champ men.
Ivan Platinik, Waverley Falcons, senior champ men.
Waverley, Tegan Cunningham, women's champ.
George Dologianis, Waverley Falcons.
Katie Bluser, Waverley Falcons, state champ.
Ilya Polyanis, state champ, women's coach at Waverley.
Mike Bullock, championship men coach, star.
No singing ones.
Oh, I'd have to say Chris Arkell and myself when we get together.
Oh, that's a tough one. I would have to say Chris Arkell. He's definitely got some great moves.
Ringwood.
I think Ringwood and us have a bit of a rivalry, so I would say Ringwood.
Can't go wrong with Ringwood. Ringwood for sure.
Tegan Cunningham.
I'd say Tegan.
I would have to say Ivan Platnik.
I would say Sid Alvin's probably myself.
Let's say it would be Sammy.
Shelby or Elise.
My go-to party trick is to grab a drink and sit down.
Shots.
Party trick. The turn and chuck.
Tom.
I'm going to have to say Tommy Boyle.
Elise?
Well, actually, it's not a player. It's Ilya Polyanis, our coach in the women's.
Ilya? Can I count him in?
Katie.
Many people ask us, what is vMix? Well, thanks for asking. vMix is software that allows you to create awesome live video productions. vMix supports a variety of different inputs to help your live production come to life. These include cameras, videos, images, titles, PowerPoint, green screen, streams, audio, and more. You can then display your production on screens, record to your hard drive, and stream to the web all at the same time. There are many different applications for vMix. Some of our customers have used it for large music concerts, school productions, live sports coverage, church services, esports, live web streaming shows, horse auctions, you name it. vMix can do it. What do you need to use vMix? At the very basic end of things, you can use a computer with onboard graphics and a webcam. If you want to bring in a few HD cameras, you'll need a bit more processing power, a dedicated graphics card, and a capture device. We have a list of recommended system requirements on our website. Whether you're an aspiring YouTube singer in your bedroom performing Phil Collins covers, or someone with an 8-camera live concert production, vMix is for you. There is a free 60-day fully functional trial on our website, www.vmixhd.com. So check it out.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we are back here, just about ready for the second half. The Falcons already 31 points down. So they are finding out why Ringwood is the top team at the moment. And they've been pretty efficient, haven't they, Liam?
Well, it seems like every time they're going down, they're either scoring or getting at least two or three chances to. They're coming up with the rebounds at both ends. They're coming up with fast breaks left and right. It's just very dominant performance from them all round.
Yeah, and dominant is right. When we look at the shooting percentages, Waverley only shooting at 13%, Ringwood at 42%. But what is most concerning for the Waverley coaches is that the Ringwood Hawks have been allowed to put up 42 shots to Waverley's 29. Of those, the Falcons have only shot two from outside, while to the four from Ringwood. And the Hawks are the only ones that have got to the charity stripe.
And also the reason for the so many shots from Ringwood is because of the rebound numbers, which is 35 to 12 at the moment. Which is just an outstanding, just dominant performance.
Yeah, the good news for the Falcons, unlike last night, Jocelyn Montesinos, the lady who's just got that rebound, is not in foul trouble. Last night she played extremely well in the first half, but picked up three fouls in the first half, and in the third quarter very quickly fouled herself out. Lola Geddes can't get it to drop. It's Watson Taylor with the rebound. Oops.
No, you're looking at the wrong game.
That man, it was Watson. I got the right one. Watson. Goldie feeds it into Nola. Nola turns. Can't get it to drop this time. Watson with the rebound and is fouled. This time it looks to be on Caitlin Angus.
So that would be Watson's 13th rebound already in this game.
Yeah, well, she's not...
No one from Waverley is able to compete with her on the boards right now. As she comes away with almost another rebound right there.
But it's Geddes getting the ball to Miller. Miller fumbles it a little bit, gets it across to McPhillips, down to Angus. Angus, two-point attempt is almost there, but there's another rebound. And again, the Falcons players not getting inside position there. Goldie can't get it to drop. Angus with the rebound.
Wanting to rip it out. McPhillips holding it up. Waiting for teammates to come down to her. Geddes got to back up top to McPhillips.
Yeah, McPhillips, when she pulls up, she has a tendency just to lift that back foot a little bit, which is what we saw earlier when she got the travel call.
Geddes back to McPhillips after the offensive rebound from Montesinos. Miller moves it to Geddes.
And Geddes steps slightly out of court.
So here we have Goldie driving in. Dished it off to her teammate there in Watson, but was knocked out of court by Waverley. So here we have everyone inbounding it from the baseline. Ball shot from the corner. Three-point attempt missed. Watson, another rebound. Offensive this time. Another offensive rebound. Puts the ball up and 2 points to her. Montesinos driving in at the other end, though. Couldn't get it to finish. As Ringwood missing their shot right there. Ball back in the hands of Miller. Miller looked like she was going to go up with it. Phillips got it. Over to Geddes, driving in the middle. Tried to get it out to Montesinos, but wasn't able to get it as it was intercepted. The ball coming down now, slow it up.
So Ravi Jerma has been excellent so far. We've been talking about Goldie driving and getting it, and she's often the catalyst for quite a number of plays. But
as Miller pulls up and makes the 2 points right there off the steal from the other end.
But Ravi Jerma just quietly goes about her business, and we saw that earlier with the intercept and steal. She's very quick down the court too as Nola turns the corner, gets it into Watson. Watson can't get it to drop. Caitlin Angus this time with the rebound. Cross to Geddes. Geddes slowing it down.
You can see Miller was running here on the other end trying to call for it, but too many players in between her and the ball. McPhillips holding it up, trying to see what happens. Miller's got it. Tried to get a baseline, McPhillips. Geddes ran out of time. Had to take the shot. But another rebound to Watson. As Ravi Jerma brings the ball down.
And foot violation there.
So we'll have Ringwood passing the ball in from the baseline. So Romas will be the one inbounding the ball for Ringwood. Gets it in quickly to Lloyd. Ball back in the corner. Now on the wing. There we have a 3-point play made there. Well, not made yet. As the 2 points go down, it was fouled. And that was by Romas making the hoop.
So Kelly Romas, 17. One of the younger players on the Ringwood squad.
And they're finishing the 3-point play. As we now have Richardson swapping for McPhillips for Waverley. So Sharsquat bringing it in. Gage dribbles around the defense. Gets it across to Scott. Geddes has the ball up top. Got it to Miller. Miller driving out baseline. Puts the shot up and just falls out as she gets fouled.
So Miller at the line, makes the first. Looking to take the Falcons up closer to that 20-point figure.
So that was Goldie bringing it down. Got it off quickly to Kelly Romas. There's Lloyd trying to drive it in, but had solid defense proposed upon her. However, a steal.
And the foul from Shah Scott. You could see clearly on the screen there.
So that's the free throw also made there by Lloyd. Some good ball passing right there by Waverley. Spalls into the corner. Up top there with Angus. Again into the corner with Scott. Tries a running hook shot. Not able to make it. Another rebound there to Lloyd. As we have Lyons dribbling it up top. Got it off to Pembry. Ball little ended up going behind the backboard as it went out of bounds. Angus getting it in. Geddes meeting a defender, Arata. Angus again up the top. Around Miller taking a three. Unable to get it to fall.
Abby Lloyd with the rebound. Cross to Goldie.
Up top there to Goldie again. Trying to take her player on. Ended up taking the shot. Where Geddes ended up getting the rebound. Almost the steal there, it looked like. But got it off to Angus in the end. Miller got it in the corner, driving baseline. Put up a floater, unable to make it. Ringwood got it down the other end. Through the hands of Lyons, now in the hands of Goldie. Into the corner. As the shot goes up, misses. Lloyd knocks it out. Ball backs end up to Goldie as it's almost across court, but a
push has been called.
Richardson fouls. Ball tried to get into the post earlier with Lloyd. But running down as a turnover is made to Waverley. Miller's got it up the top, driving in and dishing out of bounds right there. So Ringwood will take possession. The drive in by Ruby Kuma. Lloyd making her shot after a few bounces on the rim. Waverley bringing it back down through the hands of Miller. Tried to drive it in. Got it around the outside of the three-point line. Back into the hands of Miller. The drive. Geddes has it up top again. Got it off to Richardson. To Miller, and the shot clock violation is called. As Ringwood have some very strong defense to hold them up right there.
Yeah, Falcons just struggling to get the ball into anywhere where we can get a good shot off at the moment.
As Ringwood have the have it down back there, back down there, and now 3-point attempt goes up, misses. Miller fought for the ball and ended up getting it into the hands of a Ringwood player who stepped out of court as timeout is now called by Waverley. Score sitting now at 51-14. So not much more strength in the favours of Waverley.
No, we might just have a quick look at the leading scorers there.
Well, I can already tell you who the leading rebounder is without even thinking about it.
Would that be Rebecca Watson?
Oh, quite could.
Rachel Watson, sorry.
Quite possibly Rachel could. Watson.
Yeah, so as we can see there, it's really is one-way traffic for Ringwood at the moment. They are Lyons on 11 points, Goldie on 7, Abby Lloyd on 7, Watson on 6, and Nola on 5. Nola having a very quiet game so far, but she doesn't need to do anything more. She's just
the whole team is scoring quite evenly, I feel, even though Lyons is still scoring well. But
17 rebounds for Rachel Watson.
That is...
And 8 for Abby Lloyd. So Abby is close to a double-double this game.
And if Watson does keep producing as she is, she'll get another 2 baskets, no worries.
Yeah, and really, there's nobody scoring bothering the score sheet on the Waverley side.
No, not really. When you got usually a very competitive scorer in Michaela Miller, scoring only 4 points in almost 3 quarters.
She misses that. She's not being delivered the ball very well. I mean, look, Michaela, if she's set, if she gets herself into a good position, she will be very, very accurate. But the shots that she's getting up are off balance and rushed. So Waverley's got to move the ball quicker, got to get it to her in good position. And unfortunately, without Maddie Borg and Sam Lambie around, that's not happening.
Especially seeing that Ringwood can focus all their defensive attention on Miller,
yep,
without much worrying of anyone else scoring usually.
But at least the good thing is that Michaela is trying to put up a few shots. So another three attempt there did not go.
A drive in there again by Ringwood, missing as a rebound there for
Monticilla.
Giving it two more points on the board for Ringwood. As they have the ball up top now in Thruman. Miller driving in. Got it out. Two-point attempt, I believe. Just the two.
So that was Elise Thurman picking up a two.
A drive in there by Ruby Kummer.
Montesinos with the rebound, gets it across to Richardson. Back to Thurman. Thurman's shot hits the ring, but doesn't drop. That's the third quarter. We'll be back shortly. So welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. The news is not looking bright for Waverley. Ringwood up by, well, I'm not even going to do the maths. It's 16 to 53. Falcons have managed to score 6 points, 4 points, then 6 points in the quarter. At least that last quarter, Liam, they restricted Ringwood to 12. Only double their score for the quarter.
Well, with the first two quarters, Ringwood being about 20 points each, that does seem an improvement. So defense looking positive, or maybe Ringwood's easing up on the pedal. Who knows? I can't really tell.
Yeah, so Waverley has forced Ringwood's shooting percentage to drop a little bit. It's down from the high 40s down to 36. But look at that. Ringwood has had 20 more scoring attempts to Waverley. And Waverley is only shooting at 13%. So very, very poor shooting.
And on top of that, the rebound numbers, you got 50 to 21.
Yes. Turnovers, 13 to Waverley, 8 to Ringwood. And assists, 12 to Ringwood to the 3 to Waverley. Make that four to Waverley.
As
Montesinos to Miller. Would like to hear that a little bit more. Coming up after this at 2:30. That'll be, it's almost an hour's time. This game is going very, very quickly.
as we have Miller drive, moving it around her screen. Into the corner.
Yep, so in at 2:30 is the Victorian Youth Championship men's team from Waverley's. Montesinos drops that in.
Right before the buzzer.
Before the buzzer. So Montesinos picking up there. They've got to 20 points. It's not as bad as it could be. Not that it's good. As
two more points the other way through the hands of
Mozzicella. So the Victorian Youth Championship men's team will take on Sandringham. And that should be a much tighter contest as both teams are sitting down close to each other on towards the end of the ladder. They're not quite at the bottom of the ladder, but they're towards the end of the ladder.
Two more points get knocked down by who I believe it was Lola Geddes. If she's on the court, I'm probably mistaken.
Yeah, it probably was. It was probably Richardson, I think. But there's Nola doing what Nola does.
Not in the usual fashion, as I'm sure she's having a quieter game than to be expected, but not necessarily needing to have a large game this week.
Yeah. Thurman misses that. Ravi Kumar with the rebound. And she's been collected. So a bit of confusion going on here. What's going on? There is a sub.
I just feel like Ringwood didn't know who was coming off.
Looks like everyone's got it all sorted out, and we are
back into it. As a very risky pass did not pay off for Ringwood. As we have
Miller picking herself up slowly from the ground.
Never comfortable to hit the floor like that. Wood is never a soft surface.
Now you tell me. So that was what I did wrong when I kissed the ground the other day.
So here we have Waverley getting it up top to Miller. On the scene, I'll set a screen. Tried to roll off it, but Miller gets fouled. So McPhillips getting the ball in. Again through the hands of Miller. Tapped away. But got it up top regardless. Angus driving in. Unable to go through as she's fouled. So we have subs as Getty Stubbs come on as I thought she was before, but regardless.
So, as we see, Angus at the line trying to whittle into this impressive Ringwood lead. Just to give you a bit of context, Ringwood sitting on top of the Watson ladder at 14-1. They have got a 13-game winning streak going there. Waverley down at 3-12. They've lost the last two. Looks like this is going to be the three.
So that's just showing how dominant of a season that Ringwood has actually had. It's not necessarily a strong season by Waverley, but a very strong one by Ringwood right now.
Yeah, and if we look at the combined conference ladder, Ringwood sitting on top of that, two games clear of their next rival, which is Nutterwadding, three ahead of Melbourne Dandenong, and four against Bulleen. At the moment, four ahead of Knox. So by the end of this game, they will be... Well, they'll certainly be three games ahead of Nunawading, I would suspect. Waverley sitting down, just sitting above Geelong. Geelong 1-14. So, again, you know, not looking good for Waverley in terms of relegation. They need a couple more wins. They needed to get up ahead of Kilsyth and be battling it out with Hume City and Ballarat. The game against Eltham last night was a critical game for them. They would have expected to have lost this game. But so the next few rounds are going to be really, really important to them. We might just catch you up on what also happened around the league last night, particularly in terms of Waverley. We spoke about it earlier, Liam. The state champ men's team got up in the last 12 seconds, something like that. Got up by 2 points over Knox. Some fantastic efforts all round there. Brandon Polk, 20 points for Knox. Rose, 19. Polk got a double-double, 20 and 11. Hare, 13 and 8. But for Waverley, a much more spread-out effort from everybody last night. Top scorer, Dexter Kernishrew, on 20 points. Ivan Platnikov, very quiet opening, ended up with 17 and 8. Just missed out on his double-double. Chris Arkell, Matty Hodgson on 14 points each. So a really good effort there from the Waverley boys to get up over the ladder leaders, Knox. They're the only team so far to have done so.
So I believe that they've beaten them twice now, and those are the only two losses that Knox have had.
That's right. That's right. They're the only ones there. So we might. So Corio Bay, the other contender at the moment, is playing at the moment, and
currently have their final score 87-81 against Diamond Valley.
Yeah, sorry, they played last night. So that puts puts Knox on top of the ladder. In fact, this ladder looks to be wrong because they should be...
Hasn't been updated yet, it seems, with the games.
No, it should be 12 and 2 that they've got. Cryo Bay now...
would that put them to 12 and 3?
12 and 3, yeah. Waverley 11 and 3. So it's a very tight contest there. Bit of air now back to McKinnon, who have got a real late run going. McKinnon
ended up being overwhelmed by Ringwood's side last night. It was.
They did, and Ringwood has just tipped Diamond Valley out of the five. So
right now it looks like Ringwood are playing for their chances to get as high as they can on the ladder in this later stage of the season.
Yeah, so McKinnon and Ringwood tied on 9-6. But our head-to-head will go to Ringwood there. As we see McPhillips drives. Gets it back to Miller.
Long two in the corner for Montesinos.
Yeah, look, it's not going
to... Miller drive it, just smashing through the pack.
It's no way that Waverley is going to reduce the deficit, particularly not in 3 minutes anyway.
No, you can't bring back 40 points in 3 minutes. Good feats, but not that good.
They're not going to reduce the deficit if they're going to play their offense outside of the key like that and then just chuck up shots, giving Ringwood every chance to win the uncontested rebound.
Especially when they're not shooting high percentages in the first place.
No.
Wow.
So, the girls went down to...
Yes, we probably should mention the state champ women as well.
Yep, the girls went down to Knox
as well. Played right before the men.
And I haven't caught up with the coach, Elias Palihans, to find out what actually happened there. Or with any of the players. But they were relatively competitive for the first three quarters and then got blown away in the final quarter.
With the final score being 73-47.
Absolutely. So at three-quarter time, it was relatively close. So if we go to the... So it was 52-44. So it was an 8-point game at three-quarter time. And as we said...
A dominating fourth-quarter performance from Knox.
So the Falcons managed to only put on 3 points in the final quarter. That is not the kind of effort that you would expect to see from this very talented Falcons squad. But Knox... just dominant every quarter. 20-15 in the first, 16-9 in the second. Got outplayed by the Falcons in the third, 16-20, but then came back in a hurry, 21-3. So not the kind of scoreline that that we expect to be reading from the Falcons. Top scorer for the Falcons was Kate Oller with 17, 7 rebounds. She was assisted by Tegan Cunningham, who only scored 8 points again.
Well, however, she was fouled out, it appears to be.
Yeah, she fouled out in the fourth quarter there as well. Grace Beasley, the next highest scorer, with 6. For Knox, Campbell had 22, Rebecca Ott had 22. And they were the only players that got into double digits for the Knox team. So Ringwood really giving these girls a clinic here. As another 2 drops, Monticello adding to her totals. And again, scoring shared across the board. There's only two players for Ringwood who have not scored points at this point in time, Parnby and Tropino.
And on the other end, you've only got 2 players who have scored in double digits.
Yeah, but that's how much they're actually sharing the ball around, that they're not concentrating it. And Nola is normally the one that would pull it up.
And she hasn't really needed to. They've just been having such great ball movement all round.
Yep.
As a steal both ways quickly there for Ringwood and Waverley. Nice 3-point attempt. Missed again. Almost another rebound to Ringwood.
So Palmby missing her a chance to get onto the board. We're down to the last few seconds. Shot clock just a little bit in advance of the game clock. Shot from Lola Geddes quite wide. And the foul from Shah Scott
with 8 seconds left, and that's, we're in the bonus now, as that'll put them to the line for 2 points, for two free throws, sorry. But even though, as we said, Watson was on close to getting her double-double as well as Lloyd, neither of them have actually managed it at the moment. We've got Watson has 20 rebounds, which is astounding, and 8 points. And Lloyd, on the other hand, has 10 points and 9 rebounds.
So a timeout to Waverley. This will advance the ball down the court. So, again, probably even in these situations, the opposition coach or quite a number of people will think, well, why are they having a timeout here? Because you can use every one of these situations as a learning experience. So if they can come out in these last 6 seconds, 7 seconds, what have we got? Well, actually,
it's about 8 seconds, they've so got it's close enough.
About 7 seconds to go. If they can execute a play and score off this is something they can take as a learning experience.
Because you can find out if this is a play that works, or if this play doesn't work for them, this play doesn't. So it's always helpful to find what does work.
So, McPhillips to inbound the ball.
Trying to work the play out. McPhillips got it back in and out to herself. As Geddes takes the three, misses. As the two-pointers couldn't be converted in time.
And that was it. There's a whistle on the play.
There was a whistle on the play, but I think they're just going to call it there.
They are going to call it, so... There we go, ladies and gentlemen. We will be back in 45 minutes with the Youth League men's game. See you soon.